So if you find you're having trouble accessing websites, there's one trick that experts know to try right away. And it's changing your DNS to use the free Google DNS. Now, what is DNS? It stands for Domain Name System. Basically, when you go to a website, you might go to a site like apple.com. But that's not a real address. That's like saying Gary's house. It's not an address that mail can get delivered to. It has to be, you know, a street number and street and a zip code and all of that. The internet has kind of the same thing. Matter of fact, you can go to Network Utility, which comes with your Mac, and you can do lookup and type in apple.com and do a lookup, and it will tell you that, for instance, the address for apple.com is this right now. Of course, a big site like apple.com is going to have multiple addresses, kind of like an office building has multiple places. But for smaller websites, there will be a specific web address. So DNS works by translating a name like apple.com to a number like this, and that's how you load the website, with this real address that you never really see as a user. The problem is that sometimes DNS doesn't work. DNS is usually provided by your internet service provider. So your cable modem or DSL provider, your mobile provider. There's thousands and thousands of different ways you can get DNS. And quality can vary. And sometimes there can be problems with their DNS server. It's actually a whole server or process on a server that's serving up these numbers. Or their library, their database can be messed up, maybe even just temporarily, and you can have trouble. So you have the power to say, don't use the default DNS, actually use another one. Let me show you how. You go to System Preferences, and under System Preferences, you can go to Network, and then you click on whatever it is that you're using for a network. So I'm using Ethernet right here. I'll then click on Advanced, and you'll see DNS. Under DNS, you're going to see this number, and it kind of is a grayer, you know, black than a standard black there. That's kind of saying, I'm just going to use the default, whatever the router is using. So the router itself says it's going to look up DNS numbers at a specific place, probably your ISP. And it's going to just basically, this number is saying, I'll ask the router where to look these addresses up. But you can hit the plus button and say, don't to follow the advice of my router, which may come from your ISP, but I want to do a specific address. I'm going to put in these numbers here and 8.8.8.8, and then I'm going to add another one that's 8.8.4.4. Pretty easy to remember numbers. And I'm going to hit OK. And then I'm going to hit Apply. Now where do these numbers come from? Well, Google offers these numbers as free DNS. So they're just putting these out there. They have their own DNS server and it's independent of all these ISPs. This is great because it allows you to get around any problems that your ISP may have, and in the future it may help you get around things where they maybe don't want you to go to certain websites. Not so much of a problem now, but could be in the future. So now every time I actually go to a website like apple.com, instead of asking my internet service provider where is apple.com and getting the number from them, it's actually going to ask Google at that 8.8.8.8 address to give me the address for apple.com. So this can get around a lot of things. And there's also a speed difference. It could be that your ISP's DNS server is working just fine, but maybe it's slow or overwhelmed or having trouble at the moment, and that's causing pages to load slowly. So you can switch to Google's free one to basically speed things up. It's a troubleshooting technique and not something you should do if everything is working fine. But if you find you're having trouble loading websites or websites are loading very slowly, it may be something that you just want to try out. You can easily get rid of these, go back to how it was by returning to the DNS settings, selecting each one and hitting the minus button. And then you can see it reverts back to just asking your router for the DNS address. And note the reason I put two in there is because basically it'll try the first one, that one with the 4.8s, and if for some reason it can't reach that one, it'll try the second one. So it's kind of like a backup. So if something was wrong with Google's first DNS server, you would still be able to load web pages just fine until they got that first one back up. So useful troubleshooting technique. Something to know about. I like to switch it on. I find on my laptop it's very useful when I'm traveling, because sometimes while at home I have DNS going fine and I'm loading web pages fine. When I'm staying at a hotel or trying to log on in a meeting room, sometimes it's not so great and I can speed things up by using Google's DNS rather than whatever is being provided there at my connection on that end.